Hello, we are live.
We are here tonight, 9 o'clock, every Thursday night. We are here, so make sure that you're hitting that share button because we've got a great night tonight for you ladies. So it is ladies night.
I'm about to share right now. Share now. I'm share.
All right.
Share this if you are logging on. Let me check my page and make sure I have shared it.
Ladies, make sure you're sharing with your friends because everybody needs to see it. We've got a night tonight. It's just me and Alisa Lachelle, just the ladies tonight. So it is ladies night
ladies
tonight.
Ladies night. Lawrence taking a back seat and we have a show. We see he shared it. Thank you, sir. But we got it tonight for the ladies. And so we are encouraging everybody as you log on to share this video with your friends.
Remember a few years ago, Kool & the Gang had a song out called It's Ladies Night, and that's what tonight is. We're going to share with you guys how to get your mojo back, how to get your groove back, how to get it back on. You know, some things have happened in your life that have really broken you down, really torn you down, really threw some shade on you, some folks that you thought were your friends, some people that you thought who was going to lift you up, friends and family turned their backs on you, but tonight we've got a way to get that confidence back.
We have got it, and we want you guys to join us. Thank you guys as you're joining. We appreciate it. Come on and make sure you guys share it, because what I can promise you, this ladies' night conversation we're going to have is going to be what? Real,
raw,
and relevant.
As
you
always.
You don't want to miss it, because we have some stuff we want to put out there. And sometimes, Tracy, you know, women can hear women.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's good when we kind of have the whole segment and we're talking in general to the mm-hmm. people, but every now and again, ladies have to hear ladies. And
right.
sometimes, hey, Toya, I'm so glad you were able to join in.
And sometimes, Barbara, Riddick,
hey, Barbara yeah. thank you. Sometimes it's the ladies. We have to talk to ourselves mm-hmm. because sometimes some of those things don't translate well until, you know. Nicole, thank you for joining. Everybody press the share button. If you can think of one lady that might need to hear what we have to say tonight, Aretha, hello. Share this on your page. We want to make sure as many women as possible. And
right.
really, you know, it can benefit the guys.
I mean,
let me not act like it cannot.
True,
you know, if you have some issues in that confidence area, and all of us do,
right.
I can promise you we are going to be transparent tonight about some of the times when we were not so confident, because
right.
it does, you don't just wake up like this. I know everybody loves saying, I woke up like this. No, I
no,
did not.
You didn't.
And
no,
so
you
because
didn't.
I didn't, I'm honest enough to say, listen, that was a journey, and still some days.
It is. And the truth be told, I told our Bible study group last night that even going through this process with my ankle being out for 2 months. I broke my ankle March the 29th,
mm-hmm.
and then I had surgery on April the 18th, and I just got cleared yesterday to walk without a boot and without a crutch. But even through that whole process, there were times where I had to talk myself out of bed.
That's right.
I had to talk myself out of depression.
Mm-hmm.
So you don't just wake up like this, ladies. Let's just be real. Some days
real.
You feel like a queen, and some days you don't.
Some
so.
Days you just feel like, hey, Tanya, glad to see you guys. Is it freezing up? Let us know if it's freezing up on you guys. Hi, Katura. We do not want it to freeze up on you all. So let us know if you guys are not getting a clear signal so we can see if it's anything we need to do to clear it. It's freezing. It's freezing.
Okay. Katura said it's not freezing.
Brandy
Nicole
just
said, it's
it
your
is.
Phone, Pastor. It may be his phone.
Not on my end, okay?
Okay, great.
Okay, it's not good.
Okay.
Brandy, were you able to get on? Hello from New York City.
What's up?
Hi, Monica. Those are my people.
And Brandy Bailey. Brandy Bailey, hey.
Thank you, guys. All right. Well, yeah, let us know if it is freezing. We don't want you guys to miss anything because we're going there tonight.
Yep.
She's
always the wild card. So I am here tonight to be the voice of reason, because the wild card, you know, it usually takes two of us to keep the wild card contained. So I do have it tonight by myself. So y'all pray for me while we go forward. Hey, Lakeisha, what's up?
She said hers is freezing. It did it last week. So let us know, everybody. I do not want you guys to miss anything. So make sure you guys can hear us loud and clear. We might have to change location. I don't know what's going on with that. I want to make sure you guys can hear and see before we get started. All right, is everybody good?
All right, so make sure you hit the share button. So while we're getting started, let's just kind of recap what we talked about last night.
Okay.
I mean, last week. Mm-hmm. As we do every Thursday, we're here at 9. So last Thursday, we talked about compromise. And we talked about how compromise can be detrimental, how compromise can really cause us to go to places that we weren't really sure we needed to be at. And right. then what ends up happening is we find ourselves in places we never even realized we could go simply because we ended up making a compromise. And compromise doesn't necessarily go in relationships.
That's
we,
right.
You know, we can be talking about compromising yourself on your job,
That's
compromising
right.
yourself with your children or your spouse.
That's right.
So give us a little bit of what we did last week.
And last week we talked about the cost of compromise. And we just went ahead and said, listen, unhealthy compromise costs a lot. It mm-hmm. takes away from you. And we're going to talk, kind of recap some of that later tonight. But we talked about there's a difference between when you're just in a healthy relationship where it's give and take. You mm-hmm. know, I can bend a little for this and, you know, because I'm still getting what I need. And mm-hmm. so, and but then there was a difference between when you get into that self-sacrificing nature.
Right.
Where now you're just saying, here's my soul. I'm just going to give it to you and I don't get anything in return. And now I'm depleted and you're good.
Mm-hmm.
And now you've paid everything and
right.
you have nothing left. And so there's a cost for unhealthy compromise. And so go back to, if you're on the My Relationship Movement, if you've joined the team, you can go to any of our pages and watch the recap. We want you guys to make mm-hmm. sure you go back and watch that. Hi, Eva. So glad you guys joined. For all of you guys that have joined, ladies, thank you guys. Press the share button on that bottom screen and make sure that you're sharing. While we're waiting for you guys to come on, we were thinking tonight, when we're talking about confidence, one of the things, and this is kind of a freebie, that you can do to help boost your confidence sometimes is, you know, what you wear.
Yes.
Tracy and I are friends, like real friends,
real,
not just
in real life.
Facebook friends, right? And we like graphic tees, and that's why, you know, shameless plug, that's why we have a line of empowerment mm-hmm. tees. Hi, Daddy.
Visit the website.
Visit the website. And but tonight, we've decided to kind of wear some shirts that talk about where we are. Tracy, mm-hmm. what does your shirt say?
My shirt says, thinking of a master plan. Remember the song? Thinking of a master plan.
What did you know about that?
I ain't never... I'm an 80s baby.
Well, why are you wearing that shirt?
I am wearing that shirt because even when I'm at my lowest point, I've always got to be thinking of a master plan. This is just a bump in the road. When I'm having a bad day, it's just a bump in the road.
Right.
It's just 24 hours or 2 hours or 12 hours or 10 hours or 50 minutes of a bad situation.
That's right.
So the thought is, this event doesn't affect the master plan.
The master plan. My shirt says, get up, be amazing, go back to bed. And that's kind of, you know, my philosophy is, listen, get up, show up for whatever mm-hmm. is going on.
That's right.
Be present in life, whatever you have got going on. I don't
That's
care.
Right.
You know, I have to tell myself, like Tracy was just saying, whatever it is, I've got to face it. It's not going away just because I'm hiding up under the cover.
Exactly.
So not only just get up, but if you're going to get up, listen, be amazing. I say this all the time. Anybody that really knows me, I say I don't like to just be good at stuff. I like to be amazing. So whatever it is going on, I try to give it my best. That means
right.
I try to learn all I can learn. I try to not just be basic. I want to be great.
Right.
So wake up and then guess what? And then go back to bed. You need your rest. You need to recharge because tomorrow's another day. So get up, be amazing, and then go back to bed.
Right. And remember, just because you're having a bad day, a bad moment in time.
A bad moment, right?
A bad moment doesn't mean you're having a bad life. So always keep the master plan in mind. Thinking of a master plan. What is the end result?
That's right.
Because at the end of the day, like Lisa said, you go back home, you go back to bed, and you start all over
and
again tomorrow.
And you start all back over again tomorrow. So, guys, we hope you all are on. We hope you guys have hit the share button because we are ready to get started.
Woo! So tonight, ladies.
You ready for ladies night, ladies? And listen, we're inviting all of you guys. We know a lot of you guys, after you share it, you know, people are tuned in. So we're asking everybody, feel free to comment, interact. It's just us ladies tonight the house. So feel free to interact with us, ask questions, make comments. You know, we're going to do our best to make sure we're reading the screen and hit the love button. Let us know that,
Show us some love.
Impacting you guys. So let's kick this off. Tracy, we kick this off by talking about I got to see Wonder Woman. And I am a Marvel fanatic. I love superhero stories. I just do. I like, you know, the notion of everybody was against them, but some kind of way there was something great they didn't know. And then at the end, they just, you know, you break out.
And you're great.
And you're great. And you just get to be amazing. And people are like, oh my God, you. So I saw this movie, and what I think was relevant about it was I said on a post earlier that confidence really is one of the most attractive things that a woman can wear. I know we like to make sure our lipstick is good and our hair looks good and makeup is on fleek, as they say, and all of this, but confidence is attractive. And in that movie, what I noticed even from the beginning, as a little girl, her attitude was, whatever it is, give it to me. I'm ready. I'm here for this. You know, her mom, she was like, Mom, I want to be a warrior. No, you can't be a warrior. You're a kid. And she was like, Auntie, I need to be trained to be a warrior, you know. And her mom was like, no. Well, can I see what warriors wear, what they use? I'll show you, but it doesn't matter. And she's looking like, You know, her confidence level was, listen, that's in me. She had no idea. I think what was powerful about it is she never really knew who she really was until the end of the film, but that didn't stop. Every obstacle, every time there was a challenge, she stepped up to the plate. She was like, listen, I can do it. It's in me to do. And I think sometimes that's, we want to get to that place. I would love to wake up every day and see a challenge and say, hey, I'm here for that. That's what I do. I kill challenges. No, I don't. I want to run and hide. But it gave me inspiration to say, there's a Wonder Woman inside of all of us. Yeah. It's a wonder how women really do what they do. It's a wonder how we are who we are. And I think sometimes, and I think we were talking about this earlier, we don't celebrate that within ourselves, you know, at all.
Right. We don't talk about even the greatness that every woman has inside of her. Just being able, think about it, ladies. I've never had biological children. I have thousands of other people's children, OPCs. But I've never had a child myself, giving birth to a child. Think about it. Women are the only people who can physically give birth to something else.
That's amazing.
That's a warrior. That's amazing. You don't do it physically, even though I haven't done it physically, I have the ability to do it should I choose.
Right.
I'm a warrior. Even with, and my husband will tell you, even when I started walking on my ankle a few weeks ago, I would walk around the house telling myself, I'm a warrior. He would hear me saying to myself, I'm a warrior. I got this. And so you have to, every woman has a warrior in her. It's ingrained in you from the time God decided you were going to be male or female. When he made you female, he made you a female warrior.
That's good. And you know what? Really, tonight is about, I said this in an earlier vlog, we don't have little cheerleaders sitting on our shoulders saying, hey, you guys, you know, you can make it, girl. Right. Go for it. You can do it. And oftentimes, sadly enough, we don't do enough of it when it comes to each other. And so every now and again, that's where we come in. So we're coming to empower, and we are coming to equip you guys with the tools you need to be great, because that's what we always say. We want you to be great on purpose because you guys are warriors. And so we want to make sure that we're sharing that tonight, our whole conversation tonight. And this is kind of what it is. It's a conversation that we want to empower you guys. We want to enlighten. We want to equip you guys to know tonight that there are things that are confidence killers. We're going to name them, but we're also going to show you how you can still get your confidence.
Right. And one of the things, if you ever watched the movie, How Stella Got Her Groove Back, which is an older movie, if you've never seen it, for the millennials who are with us tonight, go back and watch it. But for those of us who were 80s babies, it's a story about a woman who lost her mojo and ended up in the end getting it back.
Right.
But what she got back was her confidence, her ability. If we were talking to men, she got a swag back.
She got a
so
swag.
So what do you do when life takes away that confidence?
That's
how do you get it back?
That's right.
Because ladies, let's just be honest. Life is going to hit you. Life is going to hit you hard. That's what life does.
That's right.
But what is it inside of you that gets you back up every morning?
That's right.
What is it inside of you that makes you feel like, you know what? I'm laying in this bed not feeling great, but I'm about to get up and be awesome. And then I'm going back to bed because I've got a master plan. So how do you keep yourself motivated? How do you identify those five confidence killers? So let's start with the first one.
Well, first thing we're going to do is we're going to define confidence.
Oh, okay.
We want to make sure we always start off. We like to make sure that we're aware of what we're dealing with. And so for those of you all that are joining, thank you guys that are sharing it. Make sure you share this video. Let us know if it's anything that's going on that we need to know about with technical issues. Kind of, you know,
yeah,
let
us
know.
We're looking pretty good
right now. So we're looking pretty good. Thank you guys that are joining. First of all, the definition of confidence is when you believe in yourself,
mm-hmm.
And when you believe not just in yourself, but in your power and in your ability.
Right.
It's when you have self-reliance and assurance. That comes with, there's just a knowing. Like I was saying about Wonder Woman, even as a child, when she didn't know mm-hmm. she was Wonder Woman. She was just Diana. Mm-hmm. She was just a little girl named Diana. Something in her always said, I can do that. You right. know, there was a cliff, she'll jump off. Nobody said, do you know that? You can even make
right.
I can do it. So there's that's a knowing in and of yourself. It is freezing now.
Oh, no.
Oh, no. Is anybody else experiencing any freezing? What we might have to do is switch over. Anybody else want to make sure that you guys are getting this? Okay. I don't see anybody else. I think
okay.
the count keeps going down, so that might be it. All right, so anyway, so the definition of confidence is full trust and belief in yourself. It's mm-hmm. Self-reliance and assurance.
Okay,
knowing,
thank you.
Okay,
April.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. Knowing who you are and being confident, not just in who you are, but in your ability.
Right.
Being confident in your ability to do something. And so one of the things that is always working against us, especially as women, because it's ladies' night, is there are confidence killers. Things that mm-hmm. come to rob us of our confidence. Mm-hmm. And we're going to put that out there and say, listen, here are five things that come to steal and rob our confidence. Y'all ready?
Wait. So one thing that I want to do, I want to challenge you. Get that one thing in your mind as we go through this. Write it down on a sheet of paper. Put it in your notes as we go through tonight. What is the one thing that if failure was not an option, would you get it done? Could you get it done? Failure is not an option tonight. Put that one thing in your mind. And that's what I want you to focus on the whole time we go through tonight.
That's good.
Because we are going to help kill that giant.
That's right.
That is holding you back from achieving success.
That's right.
Even in your personal life.
That's right.
So get that one thing in your mind as we go through tonight.
That's good.
Okay.
Good job, Dr. T.
Thanks.
All right. So five confidence killers. Number one. And if you want to take notes, take notes. But you could just share it on your page and then you can watch it anytime. The first confidence killer is betrayal.
Ooh, the knife in the back.
Betrayal is the knife in the back. Mm. Exactly. Betrayal kills your confidence because it makes you doubt you. When
right.
somebody betrays you, that means you've given them your trust.
Mm-hmm.
You've given them your confidence.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you've kind of said, this person, I trust them with my life. I'm going
right.
to trust them with my secret.
They're safe.
They're safe, you know. And so I must be valuable to them because I can trust them.
Right.
And so your value is associated with those people that you trust. You're saying, I trust them.
Mm-hmm.
And because they're keeping my secrets and because they always have my back, they
mm-hmm.
support me, they have confidence in me.
Mm-hmm.
And now I have confidence in myself.
Right.
But oh, when that knife comes out
and you
get betrayed, your confidence is shattered
right.
because you're saying, I must not have been that great, or
right.
was I not trustworthy? What was I not valuable?
Did they use me?
Did they abuse? Right? Did they just was that manipulate?
Mm-hmm.
Were they trying to just get something else? So
right.
they threw me away like I wasn't anybody,
mm-hmm.
and so now my confidence is gone. And so, you know, let's talk about betrayal. Why is that so devastating to our confidence?
Betrayal is devastating because when you are betrayed, your feelings and emotions are attached to this individual. When you attach yourself to somebody, when you have confidence in someone, what ends up happening is when they show you mistrust, when they do something to you that ends up shattering the confidence that you have in that individual. That's right. Your feelings and your emotions are attached because it's something about you, that individual that drew you to that person. So what ends up happening is the betrayal literally feels like a knife in our heart. That's feels right. like a dagger. Feels like the chair, the legs on the chair were taken out.
That's
the,
right.
the wind was taken out of our sails.
That's right.
So betrayal hurts.
Betrayal
it does.
Hurts.
And it will take you a while to get over betrayal.
It will.
But guess what? I've been betrayed.
Have you been betrayed? Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. But you know what? It's funny when we talk about betrayal. Mm-hmm. You know, it's ladies' night.
Let's be
so
real.
So we got to be real. You know, one of the worst betrayals when it comes to women mm-hmm. is, of course, being cheated on.
Right.
You know, you're with somebody that has told you, you are the one for
right.
me. I love everything about you. I love your pretty smile. Mm-hmm. I love the way you look.
I'm never going to leave you.
Never going to leave. Everything about you works for me. You put here for mm-hmm. custom made for me.
Right.
And then your confidence is boosted.
Right.
You're saying, whoo, somebody want me.
He love me.
He love everything about me. And I know I'm crazy, but he'll take that too. And so our confidence, again, is associated with somebody else. Now, what happens is, somewhere along the way, we lose sight of who we are to ourselves. And
so we go back and compromise or sacrifice.
Absolutely. Mm, okay. And so now we're not associating our confidence and our worth based on who we know we are. Mm-hmm. Now we're only going by this person who is saying, girl, you know, you my chocolate bunny. And we're
right.
just saying, whew, you know, I'm good then. And
right.
then, you know, he leave me for a bright skinned chick. And I'm saying, wait a minute. I'm just the wild card. And I'm saying, but I thought I was the chocolate bunny. And so
right.
now my self-esteem, my confidence mm-hmm. about what I look like. Now I'm saying, well, it must be my appearance.
Right.
Or, you know, or if you were a thick chick mm-hmm. and you saying, baby, curves rule. And then you get betrayed
right.
by somebody that is little. And you're saying, now my confidence, I was excited, I was comfortable
right.
finally about being accepted mm-hmm. and wanted, and now...
Right.
Yeah.
And betrayal even goes back to exposure.
Mm.
Because when you allow yourself to have confidence in someone else, you're really exposing yourself
that's right.
for who you really are to that individual.
That's right.
So when that individual betrays you, you feel exposed.
Yes, yes, yes. And exposure kills confidence. There is
right.
nothing like entrusting somebody
mm-hmm.
with your deepest secrets. There's nothing like entrusting somebody with your insecurities.
Right.
And you're saying, oh, this person knows I'm crazy and that sometimes I'm bipolar and they're still my friend or they
right.
still want to be with me.
Right.
And then when you get betrayed, everything just falls apart. Your confidence level says, now it's
now,
out.
Now
everybody
exposed.
Knows
right.
I'm not who I should be or who they thought I was. And now
right.
my confidence is low. And so betrayal is one of the biggest confidence killers you can have.
Exactly.
Second one.
Number two.
Failure is a
Woo.
Confidence killer. Hey, Pastor Dawn. We're on her show. She was, listen, if you guys haven't joined Crossing Bridges, find her on Facebook. They have some excellent conversations. I'm learning every time that I've joined it. So thank you for being
thank
a part
you.
Of this. The second confidence killer.
Number two
is failure.
Mm.
When you go after something
wow.
and you flunk and
wow.
you miss it. You get an F. You missed it. That
yep.
did not. I don't care if it was a haircut.
That's
you tried
it.
To try something new, and then they said, "What did you do? That's not
that
it."
That is not it.
And then you know you look like a chicken. That's not what you were going
you
for.
You look a hot mess.
Or you know, mm-hmm. or you know you went after a position and you just knew. Oh, they
I'm
got
qualified.
To choose me
because
they got. And then they say reject. You know, and that's okay. We want somebody else.
Mm-hmm.
Think when you fail at something, you know, a lot of times we take responsibility even for our children
right.
In school. I know me personally, when my boys used to just get to school and just
be boys,
act up,
be boys.
I personally took responsibility for that. It killed my confidence immediately. The failure, I translated it to me as a parent and
okay.
said, my confidence, you know, I can't walk around boasting and
mm-hmm.
saying, you know, I'm raising my kid. Because they're not doing well. They're failing. And so now my confidence has went down.
Right.
And so failure, you know, why is it that we don't have in our heads that we're not going to always win? What is it about failure that's so devastating for us? Like it's not natural.
Right, because winning feels better. Failing does not feel good. Just like for me right now, I just finished with the whole ankle thing, and the first thing I think of, I got to get back to the gym. I have got to start working out again because I feel so much better when I work out. And my clothes fit better, and I'm going, okay, I sat around. I didn't gain a lot of weight, but I gained a little bit, not a lot. And at first, I felt like a failure. I was like, how hard is it to stick to your diet? Come on, you know what to do. But then I thought about it. Wait a minute. This is just one time that I didn't do something.
Right.
But what about the last time I lost those 20 pounds? I know what to do. I know how to do it. So you look at failure. Failure isn't fatal if you're still breathing.
That's good.
You know?
Failure isn't fatal. Somebody needs to put that down somewhere. Failure isn't, if you're still breathing, and you, failure is not fatal. And I don't know what it is about us that, you know, when we were little, we all learned, if at first you don't succeed, try again. And somewhere, it translated into, go for it, go hard for it, and then if it doesn't work and you flunked on it, just let it go, give that up.
Or the one that says, shoot for the stars. Even if you miss, I mean, shoot for the moon, even if you miss, you'll be amongst the stars.
Got it. Okay.
So how is it that we figure that failure is fatal?
I don't know.
But it's not fatal.
It is a confidence killer. Nicole said, you know, nobody wants to fail. And when people shine a light on it, it makes it worse. And you're right. But I think if more people were transparent about how they got it wrong, I think more people would say, oh, now I'm not as afraid to try because they tried it and it didn't work the first time. It took them a million times to get it right. And so it actually will help somebody else say, oh, so I don't have to get it right the first time.
Right.
You know, sometimes failure can be a bad marriage. We've been divorced
before.
And so
happily married now.
But we could have easily said, that marriage failed, and so guess what? I'll never be a good wife.
Right.
I am no longer wife material because my marriage failed.
Right. And that's how we have to look at it. The marriage failed. You didn't fail.
Exactly. And so we have to stop associating ourselves to being the failure and just saying that was a failed attempt.
There you go. That's good. I
See?
Like that.
So that means, you know, if somebody's playing basketball, does it make them less of a great basketball player if they shot and it bounced off the rim?
No, Steph Curry is still one of the best.
That was a failed attempt, but somewhere he knows all I have to do is get the right conditions, and guess what?
Right.
I got it. And so sometimes we don't give ourselves enough credit to say, yeah, that was a fail. I flunked on that one, failed attempt. But guess what? Mm-hmm. As soon as I get my bearings, as soon as I stop being embarrassed and shamed, lick my wounds, I'm getting back out there
and
in the game
again.
And
do
try
it again. And that's what we do. We even when I was a gymnast, doing flips on the balance beam, and you know, a balance beam is just about that wide. That's it. And so when you would fall, it's not like you fall cute or you fall pretty. When you fall off a balance beam, you fall hard. And so the first thing the coach always said, before you can even figure out and get your bearings, to figure out that you've fallen off this balance beam, she's looking at you like, get up and let's do it again. You're still shaking it off. You're still trying to figure out, what did I do wrong to make me fall? So the next time that I go back and attempt it,
that's right,
I'm successful at it.
That's right. But you know what she was doing? She was getting rid of that anxiety and that apprehension and that fear. Because what happens sometimes when we fail, we leave too much time between when we try again. And when you leave that kind of time, you're leaving time to feel insecure. You're leaving time to be vulnerable. You're leaving too much time for
to
doubt
think.
And to say, you know what? Maybe that's, you're going to talk yourself out of everything. So don't let failure be your confidence killer. You ready?
Number three.
We talked about this. Unhealthy compromise is a confidence killer. Last week, we talked about three things that unhealthy compromise will do to you.
Right.
It will diminish you. It will dilute you. And it will make you
feel defenseless.
Mm-hmm. Like you don't have any kind of way to fight. And so, you know, again, we said at the beginning of the show that it's okay if there's reciprocity. Mm-hmm. You know, I'm giving some, you're giving some, but I'm gaining something and you're gaining something. But when you're getting it all and I'm getting absolutely nothing.
Right. That's called sacrifice.
That's called sacrifice, and it's unhealthy, and it will cause your confidence to go because you're saying, well, am I not worth the investment?
Right.
Or, well, why am I doing all the work?
Right.
You know, do you not want me back? And right. Don't get me wrong, there are people show reciprocity in different mm-hmm. ways. And so I'm not talking about somebody that maybe you verbalize, you know, how you right. feel, and maybe they show it through actions. But I'm talking about when you get nothing in return. If
and
you
we
don't
talked
do
about
it,
that last week. We right. talked about the healthy compromise, and we talked about the healthy sacrifice. As a parent, you're going to make sacrifice for
right.
your children.
That's right.
As a wife, we're going to make sacrifices for our spouses. And likewise, it should be reciprocated.
That's right.
That is healthy.
That's
there
healthy.
Are healthy sacrifices and healthy compromises. We're talking about the unhealthy ones.
Yes.
Where you find yourself giving, 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 and it causes you to be in a place where you're not receiving absolutely anything
That's
in
right.
return for what you're doing.
That's right. That's a confidence killer. The fourth one is rejection.
Number four.
Rejection. Now, rejection is different from betrayal. Rejection is somebody saying, I don't want you.
Right.
I didn't choose you. So whether that is you like somebody or you were saying, mm-hmm. I kind of want to date him, not you.
He didn't even give you a chance. He blocked you off.
Right. Or if it was a position and you were passed on, not you, I want that one.
Right.
Rejection makes you feel like, I am no longer valuable. Mm-hmm. I am not wanted. I am not desired. And
you're
your confidence.
Worthy.
Right. I'm not worthy.
Mm-hmm. Worthy.
And the
mm-hmm.
crazy part about that, though, is, you know, it's just like when people go out on American Idol and they tell you all the time, there can only be one winner.
One winner.
He can't marry five women. He's not going to date all of you. We hope he's not going to date all of you all. So somewhere we should have in there, rejection is a part of life. But
right.
we don't, and we keep allowing it to be a confidence killer.
Right. And let me put this shameless plug out there for parents.
Come on.
We have to teach our children how to self-soothe when it comes to rejection.
Mm-hmm.
Rejection is a part of life. And I'm a firm believer that when we do not allow our children to experience
That's right.
rejection.
That's right.
When we do not allow our children to experience failure.
That's right.
Like when we start having football games and basketball games and everybody gets a trophy. And everybody gets a t-shirt.
Mm-hmm.
Now, let's just be honest. When I was growing up, when you were growing up, there was only one winner.
You win.
And
right.
you learn how to handle that rejection.
That's
you
right.
learn how to handle that failure.
That's right.
But now our children, everybody gets a t-shirt. Everybody, there's a trophy for participation.
Right.
In life, there is no trophy for
you
participation.
Do not. And there are parents that say, you need to give my child something.
Right.
And nobody rewards you separately for showing up to work every day. It's what you sign on to do. Your children,
right.
except one day out of the
Let's
year in
honest.
May, are not going to wake up and apply. Oh, you good.
You're in
oh,
Yale. You're in
oh
Harvard.
My God, you're ironing. No. You wash clothes. You don't get a prize for showing up to do what it is
no,
you do. And so
do
we
not.
Have to learn. We have to get it in our head that rejection is a part of life. And what we have to do is say, you know, I might just not have been a good fit.
Right. And that's okay.
And that's okay.
That's okay.
Confidence killers. All right. Number five. Self-sabotage is
Ooh.
A confidence killer. Talk about it.
Let's talk about it. There is so much that goes under self-sabotage. We have negative talk. Ladies, we are so critical of ourselves.
We are so critical of ourselves.
Listen to me.
Talk, Dr.
We
Dr.
are our worst enemies when it comes to negative talk.
That's right.
When we self-talk to ourselves, 90% of the time, we are talking about how we don't like our hair.
Right.
How we don't like our complexion.
Right.
How we don't like the fact that we have full hips.
Right.
How we don't like the fact that our ears are not shaped like Jennifer Lopez's ears.
Right.
Or whatever the issue may be. The worst thing we can do is talk to ourselves in a negative manner, because what you hear here is what's going to manifest out here.
So are you telling me then, if it's manifesting, you're teaching me how to treat you?
Exactly.
So if I'm hearing this negative talk, if I hear you saying, oh, I always fail when I do this, oh, I can, you can't ever trust me to get that done, I'm saying, oh, I can't trust her to get that done. Or I'm saying,
right.
I can manipulate her
exactly.
because she's not confident in herself.
Because our first relationship is with ourselves.
That's right.
So if our initial relationship, if our first relationship with ourselves is not a positive relationship, then how can I expect my relationship
Impossible.
With somebody else to be positive?
Impossible.
It's not possible. The second thing that we found under self-sabotage is comparison.
That's a big one. Listen, Tracy and I are friends.
For real.
But for real. But we are salt and pepper.
Yeah, really.
Guess
really are.
But and guess what? And that's okay. I embrace. Yeah. She's the calm.
Always
laid back. I'm the
wild card
out the box, and we get along fine. Because I'm not saying I'm appreciating the fact mm-hmm. that let me call Tracy when I'm acting crazy because she's gonna be calm.
Exactly.
And when Tracy's saying I need somebody to be mad about this because I don't think she knows to call me, and I'm sending gunshot emojis. I'm ready, you know. I'm like, let's go get everybody.
Exactly.
And so it works because she's not trying to be me. I'm not trying to be her. Mm-hmm. And so we're not sabotaging our relationship
right.
because we're sitting around saying, oh, I wish I had a house like Tracy. Oh, I wish I drove a car like Elise.
Oh, I wish I was small and skinny like Elise. I mean, really, she wears like kids clothes. She's so small. And every time we go out somewhere, people can't believe that she has a 21-year-old son. But if I looked at her and if I compared myself to
right.
her, if I kept telling in my head, oh, I wish I was a size whatever she is, single digit, eventually
right.
the negative self-talk that I'm saying to myself
right.
is going to make me very uncomfortable
and
around her.
And you're
going
to start resenting me.
Exactly.
That's true. And, you know, and I got to get a shot back at her. And so Dr. T, I could be somewhere in my feelings like, well, she has to be Dr. T. She's Tracy. But I'm the one that pushed it. No, say Dr. T because mm-hmm. you earned that.
Right.
And it brings substance to what we're doing
right.
because that's something that validates what we're talking about. And I can celebrate it. And so what we're basically saying is, don't let self-sabotage be a confidence killer for you. Now, we're in the meat of what we have to say tonight. 5 ways to
yep.
get your confidence back. If you just joined, press that share button because somebody needs to know you can get your confidence back. We've outlined the 5 things that kill your confidence.
Right.
But now we're going to give you the things that build your confidence because that's what we do.
Because life is going to tear you down. You're going to have an event that's going to happen that's going to cause you to go home.
That's right.
And eat a pint of ice cream and sit in front of the TV and just have one of those nights. It's going
to
happen.
It's going to happen.
It's inevitable. But what do you do when it does happen?
Right. All of us have a story and all of us have been through something. But life is still going on. And life's not going to sit around and say, let me wait for her to get her groove back so I can keep. No, it's going to leave you if you don't jump up and say, wait, hold on. So 5 ways to get your confidence back.
All right, ladies, you ready?
You ready? Number 1. The first way is you have to redefine yourself.
Mm.
Are you who you were 5 years ago?
No, absolutely
not. Are you who you were last year?
Absolutely not.
Absolutely not. Not
even thank God.
Thank God. Not even at the beginning of this year. What sometimes the reason we're not confident in who we are is because we haven't went back to reassess the new us. We've shifted. We've changed. Things that were important to us are no longer important to us. Things that, you know, used to make us stress out, those things are not. And so people that were around us, they're still responding to us based off of who we used to be.
Mm-hmm.
And we haven't went back to the drawing board to say, hey, I might not be who I'm going to be yet, but I'm not who I used to be.
Right.
So let me redefine myself.
So there's a sea called the Dead Sea. And the reason it's called the Dead Sea is because nothing lives in the Dead Sea. You know why nothing lives in the Dead Sea? Because there is no inlet or outlet for the Dead Sea. So what ends up happening is because there is no movement in the water.
That's good.
Whatever is in the water can't survive because there is no fresh water coming
in. That is powerful.
So now when you think about yourself, when you allow yourself to stay stagnant, and you think about it, if you've ever been in the woods or ever been around somewhere where there's been stagnant water, what ends up happening? Mold ends up growing. Mildew ends up growing. And eventually it starts to stink because there's nothing fresh and new going inside of it.
That's good.
So think about yourself, ladies.
That's right.
When you stay stagnant where you are, when you stay stuck for so long, mold is going to build. Mildew is going to build, and your thinking becomes stinking.
That's right. And I don't want to be associated with somebody that is set in a dimension, that is still in a mindset, still in a dimension where they can't be open to different things, that they're afraid to go forward, afraid to embrace anything new. So my confidence is not going to be where it should be because I don't even know how to present who I am to you, because I haven't sat down and said, why am I still wearing my hair like this? That's not even who I am anymore, but that's what people are used to. And the last time I cut my hair, they said they didn't like it. They who you, you are confident when you redefine who you are. And you have to do that realistically, and you have to do it holistically. Listen, this is no longer who I am. I used to dress like this back in the day, but now some things have shifted. I'm somebody's mama. Exactly. You know, I have a different platform that I deal with now.
And I'm older, more mature.
Mm-hmm. So now there's a different way that I need to present to myself, to people, and even to me. And so my confidence rises when I move away. I put a post up because it was scriptural that said, when I was a child, I didn't just understand as a child, but I acted like one, I talked like one, I thought about it. But when I got grown, some of those things I had to put up.
Exactly. When you think about the story of Esther and the process that she had to go through to present herself to the king, Esther couldn't go to the king as Esther. And they wouldn't let Esther go to the king as Esther.
That's right.
Esther had to prepare herself to be a queen, to present herself to the king as a queen.
That's right.
So think about it. If you stay where you are forever and ever and ever.
That's right.
And never redefine yourself.
That's right.
How can you expect to be treated differently?
You won't.
Because you're still stuck in who you are.
You're still stuck.
And so how do you grow? How do you evolve? Life is about evolving.
That's right. Absolutely.
So when you stay stuck in your past, when you begin to stay where you are in the sight of pain, in the fear of pain, in the emotion and feelings of pain, you don't allow yourself to grow.
You don't.
And so what ends up happening is all these people who you thought were your friends have now started gravitating away from you. Because you're not able to redefine yourself. You're not able to evolve, and you're not able to grow.
That's good. So that's the first thing. You want to build, get your confidence back, redefine who you are. Be relevant for the you right now. Mm-hmm. Not who I used to be. You know, it's funny. My nickname has followed me my whole life. But there are certain arenas where I say, hey, you can't use that because there are people that don't.
You mean Lily?
Because there are people, right. There are people that don't know me, and I've chosen 40 years old. You're not going to be calling me something that I was called when I was 3, because when I was a child, I responded to that.
Exactly.
And so now I made a demand to say, and it leads us into number two.
Number two.
The second confidence, the way to build your confidence, use your words. Communicate.
Wow.
If there is something that you want, express it. A lot of times we are so afraid of offending somebody or losing somebody. We're trying so hard to hold on to our friends and hold on to things that we start accepting. Yeah, and we're accepting things that. And so I had to say, hey, privately, that's fine. But if I'm on a platform doing something, address me by my title or my name, because I don't want that association. People that don't know me, I don't want them feeling like they know me, you know, on that level, because they do not.
Right.
And so you have to start articulating better.
Right.
Use your words. You know, Tracy and I say all the time, I don't need anybody to guess for me. You know, confidence isn't something that you just wake up and know. It's practice.
Fall into.
Right. It's a learned behavior. And so I have to say, Tracy, listen, I don't like when you do that.
Right.
I love you and I enjoy that. But every time you kind of throw off about that, it makes me uncomfortable.
Exactly.
And you know what Tracy's going to say? Whoa. All right, I didn't know you felt like that.
Exactly.
And so guess what? I'll stop. Because she respects me. Not the power mode, just the close here. Because she respects me as a friend, she's heard my words, and she's going to say, let me respond to that. And that builds my confidence. That says, whoa, I wasn't afraid to put something out there that I wanted or that I needed.
Right. Where do your words come from? What are you feeding yourself? I wake up every morning, and the first conversation I have, of course, before I even talk to my husband, is my conversation with God. Those are the words that I'm feeding myself. But you will always find me with words in front of me, either in a daily planner. In my daily planner, I have words that build my confidence.
That's right.
Because I'm always pouring into myself.
That's right.
Because number one, I know based on the position that I have, based on the job that I have, I have to pour into somebody else.
That's right.
So I have to have words ready and available.
That's right.
Even in my everyday conversations, I was at physical therapy the other day, and the lady was noticing how I was moving my ankle. And the trainer kept saying, do this, do this, do this. And every time she told me to do it, I did it. And the lady sitting next to me, and she says, does that hurt you? I said, well, yeah, it doesn't feel good, but you know what? I got a master plan. I'm thinking of my master plan. I'm thinking of my end result. That's right. So the words that I was speaking to myself as my ankle started moving, move ankle, move in that direction. That's where we got to go. That's what we got to do. It's the words that I was speaking to myself. And so the young lady says, well, I don't know how you do it because I be in so much pain here. I said, and that's exactly what you have to change.
That's right.
You have to change the words that you're not only speaking out into the atmosphere,
that's right.
but the words that you're speaking into this atmosphere.
That's right.
Because this is an atmosphere too.
That's right.
And so I told the lady, I said, when you're at home doing your exercises, I said, you are doing your exercises at home like they told you. She says, no, it hurts. I said, and that's where you've got to change your words.
That's right.
You've got to start telling yourself, I need to do this because I need my body to be 100%. It's the words that you're telling yourself. It's the words that you're speaking out. So the words that we speak out create an atmosphere not only out here, but it creates an atmosphere in here.
So that is why using your words is how you build your confidence. You cannot be to the point where you're so afraid to say what you will not tolerate and what it is that you want.
Right.
People don't know how to address you or treat you if you're not able to articulate those. So we just said, number one, redefine yourself.
Exactly.
That will, you're not who you used to be, and so redefine who you are. And then secondly, communicate. Use your words. Say what it is. Don't be afraid. So don't hold on to people so hard that you can't tell them the truth about what you need and what you will not tolerate. Your confidence will build. The third thing.
Number three.
Our favorite one. Face your fears.
Ooh, wow.
Embrace the worst case scenario. This is what we don't like to do. What kills our confidence is the unknown.
Yeah.
Fear keeps us from going out there. So do you know what you want to do to build your confidence? Go ahead and say worst case scenario.
What's the worst
thing that could happen? I could flunk. Well, let me see. How much money am I going to lose? Am I going to be able to get that back? Come up with a master plan and then say, okay, well, then I can still go for it. Or what's going to happen if I tell that man he's going to stop verbally abusing me? Then he'll leave. Okay, well, if he left as a result of me asking him to treat me better, then that might not have been a loss. So you go ahead and put those worst case scenarios in front of you and say, you know what? If this happens, is my life. Tracy just said, Halavisha Hall is here. Thank you. She has a shirt and I'm giving her a plug. I just ordered it that says, but did it kill you? And so if it didn't kill you, Tracy just said, if you're
failure
still here, failure is not fatal.
Exactly.
And so the third thing is to embrace worst case scenarios. Go ahead and you be the first person to put it out there.
So what you're telling me that sometimes it's okay to walk away.
Yeah.
Okay. And ladies, we do that. We will stay to the very end. Won't we?
Till there is nothing left of us.
We lose ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
You give yourself away because you're so afraid of walking away. When you walk away, ladies, that is victory.
You still have your confidence. You
still
have your self-esteem. You say, my integrity is still in place.
That's I am who I am.
I am who I am.
Did you walk away?
I walked away.
And
ran, actually, ran. Ran hog tail.
I admit, I didn't walk away, but when I didn't initially walk away.
Initially, right.
But when I had the mind, when I came to myself.
Came to yourself.
Yeah. When I had that moment on the floor in the tears and I came to myself.
Right.
And I walked away. Can I tell you, it was such an empowering moment.
See? Confidence came back.
A confidence booster.
That's right.
Yeah.
All right. So, number four. How do you gain your confidence? How do you get your confidence back? Uncover your insecurities.
Ooh. Wait, you mean expose myself?
Yeah, to you.
Wait.
Go ahead and say, you know what? I don't like being embarrassed in front of people.
Mm.
If I go ahead and say that, then you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to say, no, I need to make sure that I don't flunk. So it's going to make me prepare harder. It's going to make me work harder. It's going to make me sit my happy self down and say, well, I don't like being embarrassed. I have a presentation. Now I'm going to study. I'm going to do my research. I'm going to take notes.
I'm
going to practice.
Mm-hmm.
And now, because I went ahead and uncovered my insecurity, I'm confident that, hey, okay, I already said what's the worst that can happen.
Right.
I've already redefined myself. I can do this. And I'm using my words to articulate what it is that I'm going to do. And now I'm uncovering my insecurities.
So if I want to start that business and I tell my friends I want to start that business and they look at me going, what are you thinking? I'm exposing myself So if I go back and redefine who I am because I want to start this business mm-hmm. and I know I can do it. Mm-hmm. Number two, if I use my words and I speak life into my business before I even start my business. Mm-hmm. And number three, if I face my fear and look at the worst case scenario, then you're telling me number four, I've got to uncover my insecurities.
That's right. When you uncover your insecurities to yourself first, for instance, because we're being transparent.
Right.
If you know that you can't handle rejection well. Mm-hmm. Like, I don't like people being mad and walking away from me.
Right.
Go ahead and put that, uncover that, so that you're prepared for rejection. Because we just said it is a part of life.
It's part of
Everybody will not love and embrace you. And believe me, we know the better you do in life, the less embracing you shall receive. So if you go ahead and uncover that insecurity, mm-hmm. you'll go ahead and have your worst case scenario and have a plan in place to say, if this person stops speaking to me, if this whole group of folks mm-hmm. don't support me, am I still able tomorrow to get up and do it again? Right. Because I've uncovered my insecurities, now I am better prepared and confident. Guess what? I'm putting this post up, and you know what? I got 12 likes. I don't care.
Right. It doesn't make or break
I've already uncovered my insecurity about it. And now mm-hmm. I'm saying, is it really about that? Or is it really about putting that information out there
right.
where somebody can get, see, there's a plan that's bigger than me. And mm-hmm. so, like I said, wake up, be amazing, and then go back to bed.
Right.
And so in my head, if I say, listen, as long as I put everything out there, my insecurities, am I pretty enough? Am I articulate enough? Am I relevant enough?
Am I ready to
start
the business?
Am I ready enough?
Am I ready to go back to school? Am I ready? Can I lead a song
right.
at church on the praise team?
Right.
Ladies, this goes for everything.
You get stuck in that forever if you were not at the point where you could just say, listen, let me uncover all of it. Let me just look at it.
Mm-hmm.
Let me face them and just say, that's what I'm insecure about. So if I'm looking at it, now I can work on it. You can't fix what you don't face.
That's it. And so what do? How do you fix that? Write the insecurity down and then write how you fix it.
That's right.
One of the things that I did when I got ready to open up my private practice was, how do I do that?
Mm-hmm.
Can I really have a successful private practice in Albany, Georgia?
That's right.
Who does that?
Right.
I went out and I asked people. I started working with people. I started asking questions only to find out that one of the things that I couldn't do was ask questions. So did that mean that I needed to close the practice?
Mm-hmm.
No, that meant that I had to talk to myself and say, you know what? If this is in my heart, this is in my heart for some reason.
Right.
And because it's in my heart, I'm going to work hard at it. And I did. And I'm still working at it. The business is still evolving. As
That's
a matter
right.
of fact, we got some things coming out that we're going to do through the business. And it's still evolving.
Still evolving. That's right.
It's still going forward. So even if it slowed and my insecurity started coming up going, well,
let me go ahead and look at that and say, what am I afraid of? I'm afraid that people won't take my services.
Exactly.
So then guess what? Because I face my insecurity, I'm going to call Elise and say, listen, what can we do to make
exactly.
sure my marketing is on point? Because I can't fix what I don't face. So because I faced it, mm-hmm. now I can come up with a solution for it. It will make, doesn't it make you feel confident when
exactly.
you know that your marketing's on point?
Exactly.
Because that's a fear now that you've laid to rest.
It's the insecurity that I exposed.
You exposed and it was
that's
able
it.
To get fixed. So number five.
The last one.
The last
five.
Way to get your confidence back. Find something about yourself to celebrate every single day.
Exactly.
I don't care what it is. If it is your smile, if people have told you forever, mm-hmm. you have a beautiful smile. When you smile, that lights up. You hold
right.
on to that. And you say, listen, I'm going to make sure I get the best toothpaste. And I'm going to do those whitening strips. Every selfie I do, I'm going to, throw that smile out there. Whatever that is that you can say positive about yourself.
Right.
You know, if you can't focus on everything that you don't like. Because we'll criticize ourselves too.
To death. That's what women do.
So when you celebrate, when you find something, and it mm-hmm. doesn't matter, does it really even matter what it is that you're celebrating?
It doesn't matter what you celebrate. We all have to be, let's just be truthful. There are some times in our lives where we've had great moments. I call it mountaintop experiences.
Right.
Everybody has a mountaintop experience, and
right.
you have to remember those experiences.
Right.
Because just like you have mountaintop experiences, you're going to have valley experiences.
Yep.
And it's those mountaintop experiences that help get you out of the valley. Hey, I want to say hey to Kathy Cardison. What's up? She's one of my coworkers at Westover. Thank you for joining us tonight.
so that finding something to celebrate about yourself every day. You know what's important about that? It's not really what you're celebrating. It's that you're celebrating.
Exactly.
It's you're creating a habit of affirmations. Exactly. I'm the empowerment specialist, and so what I have to do is every day, mm-hmm. it's affirming yourself.
Right.
It's saying, if I hear myself, if I'm teaching me mm-hmm. to hear good things about me, I will be less apt to receive negative things
right.
that are spoken over me. And
right.
so now if I've been telling myself, Elise, you are articulate. One thing you can do is communicate.
Exactly.
So don't you be afraid to say what you have to say because you know how to say it. Then when somebody comes along saying, oh, I wish you'd stop talking so much, the confidence, the affirmations that I spoke to myself mm-hmm. says, hey, but what I'm saying is positive, it's relevant, and it's helpful. Thank you. I appreciate it. But this is my platform. You're welcome to get your own, and this is what I'm going to do. See how my confidence just got... I'm not confident. Like we just said earlier, I don't wake up like this. We don't wake up with this boldness.
Like this.
What we have to do is practice. And we do have one bonus. Here's the bonus.
Number six,
the bonus. How to get your confidence back, and I think this is the most important one. Look for good in others, and then
always
celebrate it. Find somebody else, another woman, another anybody that's trying to do something.
Mm-hmm.
I don't care if they've done it well or if they're trying it. You will never know how empowered you
yes.
feel when you say something positive to somebody else. When you hear yourself, Tracy, Dr. T, you know, she's out there moving mountains and carrying on. But guess what? It doesn't stop me from sending her
being great.
It doesn't stop me from sending her, and she'll tell you, I'll send her a text and
yes.
say, listen, chick, you are awesome. You
she
are
does.
Slaying that.
Mm-hmm.
And she'll see I posted something and say, listen, I'll get all kind of fist emojis and you
yes,
can
it.
Do it. And you know what that does? It empowers me
Both
because
of
I'm able
mm-hmm.
to celebrate her,
mm-hmm.
and it empowers her that she, and you know what we're doing? We're killing pettiness. We're killing jealousy.
Exactly.
We're killing self-sabotage.
Exactly.
We're killing insecurity.
Exactly.
All those things that are confidence killers,
mm-hmm.
when we learn how to celebrate somebody else and then not just celebrate it in the DM
right.
or not just quietly, publicly
wow.
say, that's my
that's
friend.
It.
That's
it.
Listen, congratulations on what you're doing. Way to go. We are embracing and empowering ourselves and somebody else, and that's the biggest confidence boost you can ever have.
I hate reality shows. I'm just going to be honest. Let's just be honest. I hate the reality shows where the cattiness between the women
right.
Just tears us down. So what I try to do is when I am around women, and my coworkers will tell you this, I love to celebrate them. When they're doing great things, and don't mess around and tell me you got a goal. Ooh.
Pusher.
I am a pusher. I am a personal cheerleader. I will push you until you achieve it. I'll send you a text
yes,
early in the morning saying,
God.
What you doing? I'll send you a text at night talking about, what did you do? I just love encouraging people. I love pushing people. And that's where my strength comes
that's
in.
Right.
When I see Elisa doing well, I don't get jealous of her when she's out there being great. She is blowing up and being great right now. I'm not jealous of her, but I celebrate her because I celebrate myself.
That's right.
Let me tell you, one of the things, and don't, y'all don't laugh. This is ladies. Ladies, I'm being real with you.
Uh-oh.
One of the things that I do when I know I have a challenge that's coming up, there's a song that I love to play in my head. And I know the song is this, and it, the words are not that great, but I like the lyrics. It hypes
wait.
Me up.
Okay.
It hypes me up. It's Eminem's song.
Uh-huh.
And it starts out,
okay.
dun, 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 and I feel like Rocky, you know, I'm getting it on, I'm in the mirror. And it goes, lose yourself in the moment. And I'm like, yeah, that's me, I got it. And the warrior comes out, the Rocky comes out, you know, and I feel like I can do anything. I feel like a warrior. I feel like there's nothing I can't do. And so, ladies, one of the things I want to tell you as we wrap up tonight is get that song in your head. What is that one thing, though? What is that tune that gets you just there, that makes you feel
you
like a
mind?
Warrior? What is yours?
Y'all gonna laugh. Now, as you can see, she's the thug. Mine, when I have an only daughter, I always talk about her. When I was younger and she was younger, and she would see me, I was trying to be Miss Fix-It at my house and
uh-huh.
put together little dressers, and they always had a gangster lean because I didn't quite ever get it right. But I would be tired and I would be sitting on the floor like, and my little daughter would come in and she was in pre-K and she would say, come on, mama, you can do it. Put a little power to it. And I was like, yeah, I can do it, you know. And she's, that's my hype up song. And so somewhere I hear her little voice and saying, come on, chick, you can do it. Just put a little power to it. Put a little more effort and you don't even know what you can do. So I'm not thugging out with Eminem, but same effect, whatever that chant is you need to have in your head. Yep. If it's replaying this video and hearing us say to you guys, listen, be confident because you're unique, you're special, you're amazing, you have a plan, you were put here for something.
You are awesome.
You can achieve it. You know, we don't say enough great things about each other, but because we're confident in ourselves, we know how to be confident and support other people. So if you're out there doing amazing things, tomorrow, wake up, be amazing, and then go back to bed so you can start all back over and get yourself a master plan. We hope you guys have enjoyed Ladies Night. We've enjoyed sharing with you. One thing we want to tell you before we leave, you know what? You are worth the investment. Thank you guys.
Good night, ladies.